Beautiful day.
Time for a ride. 2 beers.
For the journey.
Log jam. Smash whilst East Saison. Check out the Walls Brewing for that. It's basically a smash brew using single ingredients. Inspired by it all. And also the Silver Spur, because I'm riding my bicycle. Super pale ale, 4.6%. American inspired, and Silver Spur. But yes, going for a little ride. Enjoy the sunset, sunshine. And then on to helping my father with the garden. So I said to sort out, beautiful today, but yeah, first up is the logjam smash, or logjam smash, Wild East Saison, from Lord Brew. So they created it by using a single malt, single hop saison, and the fruit put actual logs into the brew. They used logs of olive and silver birch. They used Maris Ottermalt and Sars hops. So if you want to see the journey of this beer, check out Instagram and YouTube via the Lord Brew pages. Yeah, it's beautiful today. Outside the salt beer factory. So beer pass. Very funky honey brown. So it's very murky to see. Like a lava lamp kind of colours to it. Almost like an amber nectar approach. Minimalistic Ed. Purchased these via the Lord's Brewing website. Cheers. Lots of green hop peel. But yeah, apple peel. And almost like apricots, I'd say, but it's a bit. Probably stuns it. Oh, cheers. Slightly tart. It's almost got like a black tea element to it. But yeah, apple peel, definitely for sure. So relaxing. It ain't really bird too quick. Blue skies and sunshine. But yeah. Very unique beer. Yeah, definitely check out the YouTube page of Lord's Brewing for the process of this beer. Go in more detail. But it was in at 6.8%. They've used wild yeast. But yeah, it's very cool. Sit, relax for this, enjoy the, well, semi-peaceful views with the cars going this way and that way. But yeah, blue sky, sunshine, on the bike today, and gardening with her. So the more you aerate and small sips, the better it improves. All that underlying tartness of the apple peel, but some vanilla components to it coming through. Juicy fruits. It's a lovely beer. I'm enjoying it. Just blue skies and shine. Birds to eat. So, back in Bradford, had the first half of the can outside the corn dollar. Chat to Anthony, one of the owners, or barman, or proprietor of the roast, well. One of the linear bar. But all the pubs are open in select areas over the UK this next couple of weeks, and then the next month. So, the Silver Spur. Now, back in the old days, in Westerns, you would show your authority by adding spurs. You showed direction, aggressiveness, and determination. And the better the spur, the wealthier you are. So if you acquired the Silver Spur, it means you were of wealth. It's actually an homage to America kind of thing. It's quite tasty. When I'm having the first half of the can outside the corn dollar, it was very zesty, with lots of lime. Took me back to when I had a key lime pie in America. So it did its job. So I've got the second half now. It's outside one of the statues here in Bradford. Is Victoria, who reigned from 1837 to 1901. Not sure a reference to Bradford is, but it's just nice at Bradford's showing tribute. So, it's disappeared now, obviously, because it's been a while since our last product. Nice homage to the soldiers of Bradford, memorials to the memory of the soldiers of Bradford Pals and the other servicemen of West Yorkshire who served in the Great War 1914 to 1918. The rest of it's covered up with poppies, some of it with plaques and stuff, but it's pretty cool. Cheers. It's very punchy, as it says on the tin. It's very lovely, it's relaxing. And it is a soup pillow, to a degree. In effect, it punches you and lets you out. Nice pie-ness in the end. But yeah, key lime pie. But yes, it was nice. Definitely chat to Anthony and all the barcode people that I've known for a while since mail drills. Some stories are always one of the highlights of going to a pub. Speaking of such, the Laws Brewing, they do live at the brewery every other Friday, or is it every Friday? I've always started watching them. But yeah, but just from the brewery, just like the others. Look forward to the stuff over the course of today. Anyway. What's this? So I'm home. I've got the Drunken Pilsner. 4.9%. The Gentleman Beer. Pale Gold. The Drunken Tailor is the result of two companies dedicated. Ah, yes, sir. I looked into it. So Owen Scott is a bespoke tailorer. Tailoring. There you go. Basically, Lord's Brewing. So basically, the try to work. So, see how it works. The skills of a bespoke tailoring firm, and then Lord's Brewing. All the information is on the website, and I've got my food. I'm just like hungry after a cycle. It's just like hailing. It's like a combination of snow and rain. Cheers. Yeah, so I got back. But I just got back, and the first thing I wanted to try was the Pilsner. I've got the Bandon Car. Bandon Car? After I've eaten. But it's pairing well with the chicken. I was passing the fish shop. And I hadn't had proper chips for a while. They always taste better when someone else cooks them. But yeah, snow and ale. Nice, solid beer. Lovely artwork. Anyway. Enjoy food. So, just bringing off the phone to our parents. It looks like today's gardening is either postponed or cancelled. So, in the process of putting this in around... Oh, wait. I didn't do the opening. But anyway. Now, the Bandon Car, depending which website you used for information, it is classed as different styles, but the actual Lord's Brewing have actually done their own beer review of this, and I had a message on the YouTube comments, and basically, when it was in bottle, it was a little more denser in flavour and texture. Can was a bit more lighter in texture. But processes change. Snowballs. It's dissipating really well, so. Anyway. Yeah, so when he reviewed it, it was labelled on his YouTube as an Irish porter. I think it's on the internet as a stout. Or is that the other beer I've got? 1 second. The joy of being home. It's relax. So there was some slight errors in. Ah, so it was the Sunset Cocoa paw. Okay. But yeah. This on the internet says 4.8. The can says 4.8. That's good. Anyway, beer in the glass, dark, which is should be. It's disappeared now, so it's been a while. Cheers. Ooh, that's nice. Get a bit of charcoal like flavour to it. A little bit of on the licorice side. That's hard work. So this is what... So, as always, when I do my research on certain beers, so the Bandon Car is an Irish folk song. I put the link in the description below to check in. I have. Yes, by Jimmy Crowell. It's the Bandon Car. And I think it's on the Lord's Brewing, but basically, the Bandon Car is a folk song penned by Irish ballad Kevin Beale. Ah, so I've got Jimmy Crowley. It was the first one that came up. So, and balladeer Kevin Beale, which cautions pub goers in West Cork, in Ireland, to beware of the seemingly obnoxious Garda car patrolling. Garda is Irish for police. Area essential of drink drivers, this well-balanced porter is rich and satirical. Attribute to County Cork. But yeah, you can see there, that's the Garda car. But yeah. Lovely. Yeah, I put the links for Jimmy Carroll and his version of the Bandon Car folk song. That's the first one that came up. I suppose if you are making a tribute to an Irish legend, She doesn't make an Irish pot. This is a lovely beer. Anyway, that's what I was going to say. I think, yes, I've got three left. Yes, no. So yesterday, all this was out there. Dense. The mud's clear, it looks nice now. So when we progress, some of the tree work we've been doing over the past 2 years. Some thatching there. Fencing repaired and put back up. Planting, birdhouse. Mostly done now. Cleared most of this out. Got leaves and such. Trimmed about the trees. Mostly still got to skip. That should be good in a few more months. Beautiful. Sun's coming out now. Time for a beer. So this is based on California Pale Ale. Oh, it's a West Coast Pale Ale. So basically, they've brewed it on the California style. And it's a Pale Ale. California's in the West Coast. So Mount Helix. Mount Helix is in California. The information is in the description below. Right, honey brown. Yeah, sun's coming out now. Brief snowstorm, but it looks like it's gonna rain shortly, so I'll make this quick. Light off white brown, there's like some brown in the head, but it's pretty murky for West Coast. It looks more like a brown ale more than anything else. Very murky. It's not true. But yeah, there's no transparency at all. Kind of looks like a brown ale, but I'm a fan of the West Coast style. I've been to California. It was my first ever American adventure. Like orange in the aroma. I've noticed that a lot of the lager beers you get to agitate a lot in between drinking. Cheers. It's like a brown ale. It's alright, it's nice. So after the Bandon Car, I thought, you know, it's snowing, it's raining, I've just had a large meal, I had a nap, woke up, turned the remainder of the Bandon Car, which still is on form. Then came down to see my parents. The garden's coming along really well. We did a lot of it around this area as well, cleaning inside it. But yeah. Trips to the, what do you call them now? Tip. I think that's simple to tell. Now, speaking of tip, when I tip this, it's not a very good representation for West Coast, but it is a tasty beer. Getting lots of like oily notes. But yeah, it's a little, very similar to a brown ale. It's strange. 60. It's normally supposed to be dark in colour, but not that much dark. Agitating, but yeah, you get an orange zest, kind of. More ivy. Ivy gets everywhere, seriously. I just crazy rash from it. The ivy had like spikes. But it is a really nice beer. West Coast, not too sure, but it is a nice beer. I think it's great. Every beer I've had from the lots, I've got inspiration from somewhere. So the final two beers, the fourth, fruit infused, fiend, should I say. So the Roy is based off of the it's the teddy bear of one of the brewers, can't remember. The head brewer. So it's a Cranberry infused pale ale. Check out the beer review in the description below, Chris's beer review. This is the Sunset Cocoa Chocolate Orange Porter, inspired by a famous Critical Orange flavoured chocolate confection. You know the one. The porter is stacked with cacao nibs, sumptuous dark malts, orange zest, vanilla and lactose to create a beer that soak into a dessert you might spoon. So, fun fact, I've noticed throughout the beers I've had today from Lords, the conditioning in the cans isn't, and the bottles, but I did see that they mentioned that they had canning troubles and the fact that they're hoping to get their own canning line, and it's going to be, when they finally get it, it's going to be high end and high quality. But look forward to having their beers on cask, but let's dive into the beers right now. So, the cocoa, Sunset Cocoa. Now, I managed to enjoy the sunset with my father yesterday after doing the garden. Light brown head, chestnut brown, some light redness in there. It does kind of smell like chocolate orange. You know, it's not terrible. It's slot. There's almost like a dampness about all the beers I've had today. And they all have like woody characters, but like on a damp end. And right today, when I'm walking around the garden, yeah, cheers. Nice creamy lactose, light body. I can see it being better on cask, but. It's showing on the label, like riverbeds and stuff like that. I've been to Huddersfield many times, palm trees, but they seem to have a lot of inspiration with America in the beers I've had today. It's tasting nice though. Right, so. This is Roy, a beer inspired by the Edinburgh's teddy bear, pink, maybe for the cranberries, or basically because the bear was pink, who knows. Now cranberries are a dietric, remember, I know when my ex's, I think it was auntie or something. She had some lot of cranberry out coming out of the hospital. Similar colour to the Helix. Now the thing about the Helix, I had like a third of the can left, so I thought, you know, I'll enjoy that in my garden, relax. So put it into glass, put it down, knocked it over. It was good though. You could tell there was quality there, but it was like there was something holding it back. But once the pubs reopen and I get to go to Huddersfield again, hopefully I get to try a lot on the cask. And I'm sure it's all different kind of bowl. Cranberry is evident in the front. We always asked to drink it when I'd always visit my ex's family and things like that. I think my mum used to drink it a lot as well. Yeah, she used to. When I did this shopping over the pandemic. Yeah, cheers. She'd always offer me a glass. I feel good. Apparently, you're not supposed to drink too much cranberry juice, but the little one can. That's good. So, it was at 5.8%. The cocoa, Sunset Cocoa, is at 4.3. Nice sessionable level on both. Nice balance on this. Went through really nice. Cranberry, really prominent. It's rare to see that in a beer with berry infusion. But this is the, it's got cranberry puree. But aroma and taste, you get cranberry. I've not seen too many cranberry beers, I don't think. I've seen it in ciders and wines. But they used the Dana and Yule Melon hops for the Roy and Dana and Brown and Cross for the Sunset Cacao. Two lovely beers. All the beers I've had have been good today. Put on Lord's Brewing, purchased via the website. Yes, it's strange having a small brewery that's just starting out. It's just like, normally I'd be in a pub or a beer festival, sampling there. But yeah, the first time I had Lord's Brewing was at Bradford Beer Festival. But yeah, now the chocolate orange porter was classed on Untappd as, I think it was a stout, and the ABV on the Roy was different as well. Well, that's 5.8, and that's 4.3. Anyway, check out Lord's Ruin. You take care. Goodbye.